So I'll be comparing GPT-5 against Anthropic's Claude models when it comes to coding in real-world production code bases. I find that whilst many models do well on these one-off applications, like this French adventure game that they made in the livestream, that performance doesn't necessarily carry over to coding in a real production codebase. The codebase that I'll be editing is this application that I made called Tensor AI, and you can download it on the App Store using the link in the description down below. And it basically helps stay up to date with the latest AI news, so I have it on my iPhone over here. And you can see all the AI news that happened today, including like GPT-5 dropping and some other AI news. And I can listen to a summary of this as well. And if you want to learn how to make applications just like this, then you can join my AI Startup School, where I teach you how to make applications from start to finish and get users and distribute them and also like get sales and so forth. The change that I'll be making is adding Japanese support to the application, because someone left a review saying, can you add Japanese support? And I'm going to make it so that every article, like as it's generated, is also written in Japanese, and you can also listen to the AI news in Japanese as well. And then all the like settings and so forth are written in Japanese too. So I'll give this request to GPT-5 thinking and also Claude for Sonnet thinking. I'll be using Cursor in this case and just changing the underlying model to make sure it's a fair comparison. So I'll use Super Whisper and say, hey, basically I want to add Japanese support for the XP application. I want to make a translation keys file that has all the translations, everything on the application in Japanese. I also want the articles that are generated by the AI when it comes to generating the AI news in Japanese as well. I also want the daily audio summary in Japanese too. You have to make the database migrations for this. And I also want a setting which like it automatically matches a user's language, so they can choose device language or they can override the device language and choose either English or Japanese. Basically download the relevant packages, add the support for this, add the database migrations, and just anything else that is required. And I'll press stop and then just copy over this prompt over here as well. And this is running in two different folders with the exact same code base. So this is running in the GPT folder and press enter. This is running in a Claude for Sonnet folder, press enter. So I'll just be speeding up this part of the video and then showing you what results it gives. So it seems that Claude for Sonnet is already done. So I'll wait until GPT-5 is done, compare the solutions and see which one performs better. Okay, so GPT-5 is done and it took about double the length that Claude for Sonnet did. And it seems to have changed more files as well. So firstly, we'll apply the migrations and then see how it performs in applications for in both cases. And then we'll compare the code. So I'll just write npm install to install any missing packages. And then I'll apply the migrations that just happened. Finally, I'll run npm run start and then see how it looks inside the application itself. And yeah, it seems to have run into a problem with a missing semicolon somewhere. So I guess I'll just quickly copy this and then give it back to Cursor and we'll see how that performs. And I'll try again on the application. And I think in the settings, it should have added a language feature. So I added language over here, device language, English, Japanese. And it seems to have added some Japanese to the application. So it added the theme and the like language itself, but it hasn't changed the translations over here. It did change the translations for theme, I think. No, it didn't add them here. And for the rest of the application, it just did not add translations throughout the application, unfortunately. It is trying to load the Japanese version of the AI news, and I think it's like failing to load that. So it says no articles found, which is good. But it's disappointing it didn't add the translations itself. So even when I checked the translation keys file over here, it only added a tiny selection of the translations like that were required for the application. So just looking for the database migration that I made, it looks pretty good, but we're going to check if it works by actually generating articles in different languages. So now I have the aggregator running, which is fetching all the Twitter accounts and all the relevant news. So we'll see what happens here. So it seems it has generated some articles about the news. So we'll see what it's like. And it seems that there are some English ones and some Japanese ones. If we reload the mobile application, then we should see some Japanese articles over here. So it's loading the Japanese ones, but initially it loaded the English ones. And these are all the Japanese ones over here. This looks pretty good, but it seems to be struggling with actually combining the audio and like basically it seems to have made a mistake over here where it doesn't have a written summary anymore. But yeah, that should be a pretty easy fix. But yeah, reading through the code, that's a really easy fix right over here. So I can press keep and then save that. So yeah, after making that tiny fix, it then generated the audio properly. It also generated in Japanese, and then it also sent push notifications for every article that was generated. So I can see on the application, and if I press refresh over here and then go to like the audio.
Tensor AI Daily Digester.
And yeah, it just made a Japanese version over here, which is like really cool. I think the only things that it missed is it didn't add the translation keys for everything else on the application, such as like update interests on the onboarding and so forth, but that can be fixed with another prompt. And it broke the loading thing over here, so it's always stuck on loading. And finally, when it came to sending push notifications, I checked for the code. It doesn't actually check if the user's language preference matches the like push notification it's sending. So it should only send Japanese push notifications to Japanese users, and it should only send like English push notifications to English users. So it did not consider that at all. There's like no indication that it was trying to do that at all. But that can be fixed in another like prompt. But overall, I'm like very impressed with how well it's done. I know it's done better than other OpenAI models before, because there's no way that O3 or like GPT 4.1 would have been able to do this via cursor. Anyways, we're going to check for the solution that Claude Sonnet gave us. So I just started running the Sonnet version of the application. So if I go to settings again, I can see it says language, and it added a interface language and also a content language. I find it quite interesting it made a distinction between the two. So let's go with Japanese on both of them. And I think that's actually very impressive. So like, I did not think of doing that, but I actually would have preferred that as a solution. And changing the language, it changed a few things over here. It didn't change themes, manage notifications. It didn't add translations to these things. It added translations, and yeah, it didn't add translations elsewhere either. As for the database, I tried to reset the database to apply the migrations again, and it seems it ran into an issue over here. So one of the migrations, or like one of the tables it's referencing, does not seem to exist. So let's quickly fix that. So now I'll run the aggregator one more time and press invoke over here, and then see what it comes up with. So it's fetching the Twitter accounts, it's like going through the articles and so forth. So looking through the Claude 4 Sonnet version, it did not generate any Japanese articles. So I looked for the code base to find out why. And basically it checks that if there are any Japanese users like on the application, and if there aren't any users with that language preference, then it just does not generate an application. And what it does is it translates the English articles into Japanese instead of just generating brand new ones based on the content, which the OpenAI one was doing instead. So I actually prefer the OpenAI solution in this case rather than just translating articles, because it would have more context to write a better article that's more natural for that language. It also makes a Japanese system prompt as well, which is pretty good, I guess. It didn't have to do that. It could have just, say, like, write in Japanese instead. So now after updating my language preference again, it does actually generate in Japanese, but it only generates the content in Japanese and not the subtitle or title, which seems slightly annoying. So I think that solution is worse off. We'll see if it generates the audio as well. And looking at the database, it seems it did not add like a language column to the articles database. So it's how is it meant to know which article is Japanese and which article is English? But it didn't check the article language when it came to sending push notifications like GPT-5 did. So it made the same mistake, or like it did not implement the same thing. So if I go back and then I like refresh over here, I can see there are two articles. And one of them is in Japanese, and the other one is in English. So honestly, the title should have been in Japanese as well. It should have only fetched a Japanese one, which it didn't. But the audio summary for today is actually in Japanese, which is good. So yeah, I actually think that I prefer GPT-5's solution because it added the relevant database columns, which is a language column over here. Even though Claude 4 Sonnet's added a language column to the audio summary, it did not add it to the articles. And I don't like the way that it was generating the articles, where it just translated the article to Japanese instead of having it generate it both in Japanese and in English, which is possible with a single prompt. But yeah, honestly, I feel like GPT-5 at first glance wins on this one. I'm sure that Claude 4 Sonnet would have done better if I used it via Claude Code or something instead, or it would have done better if I used Opus instead. But Opus is very expensive. And also, I think that GPT-5 is actually cheaper than Claude 4 Sonnet. So honestly, I feel like I might just be using GPT-5 going forwards and seeing how that performs. I'll still be using a mix of both so I get a feel for like how they perform in the long term and make an update video about it. So if you do want to stay tuned for that, then do subscribe to the channel. And I guess for now, I'll be finishing off the update using the version that GPT-5 generated, and then I'll update the app screenshots and description and stuff to include Japanese as well.